This segment brought to you by Gutierrez Law Firm.
Y bienvenidos a Arizona Barrio Stories. Yo soy Román Reyes y este segment va a ser el arte que nos impulsa. That is the art that inspires us and drives us. First of all, let me show you where we're located at. If you just follow me. This is First Street, Washington. And then we have Adams over here. So if you're coming by, just come on through the alley, just drive through. And today we're going to be looking at El Callejón de Alec. Come on. Here we have a depiction of Kukulcan and his sister. Kukulcan is a legend in the Mayan era, where he is the feathered serpent for the Mayans. The Aztecs had Quetzalcoatl, which is the feathered serpent for the Aztecs, but the Mayans had Kukulcan. The legend goes that when he and his sister were born in a cave, he got too big, and so he had to leave the cave and he went into the ground. When he went into the ground, he caused earthquakes and tremors. And so now in the Mayan area, whenever there's earthquakes and tremors, it's Kukulcan telling his sister that he's still viable, he's still alive. And follow me. Here we have depicted a deity, and on top of that is two young men, a lady and a man, celebrating their graduation from college. So they're building their education based on their ancestors. So this kind of, that's what this depicts. Continuing here, what is a pueblo without a lowrider? So this kind of depicts the lowrider image that we have. And this is old Chevy. Now if you look on top, we have celebration. This is the good times. This is Dia de los Muertos, where we honor our ancestors, and we have parties at the cemeteries, and we offer things that our ancestors like. So we bring food and things that they like. On the bottom, here you have Selena, and I just love Selena. She was so wonderful. I hope you've seen the movie. This depicts her. And once again, she is part of our culture. Next to her, we have Folklorico. And one of the things about Folklorico is that, once again, the gaiety and the fun that we have with watching the dancers, learning all of the cultural aspects of it. Each area has their own style, their own culture, their own dress. So that's what this depicts. As we move along, we come to the legends. This is Cesar Chavez, who formed the Farm Workers Union. And then next to him is Dolores Huerta, who, by the way, she just had a 91st birthday, so she's 91 years old. And she has an organization, a nonprofit organization, that helps activist people put together organizations that help with diversity. And once again, Cesar Chavez is a widely known icon in our community. You see on the bottom here, si se puede, yes we can. She coined that phrase and we're still using it today. Cesar Chavez came to Phoenix quite a while back, and Jose Andres met him I only saw him when he was at Santa Rita Hall, and he was very frail. He was fasting, and so you really couldn't talk to him, but he was very inspiring, and he was very dedicated to the cause. Follow me. Here we have Silvestre Herrera. He is a local homeboy. He got the Medal of Honor, and he passed away not too long ago, but he was a homeboy, and you see depictions of soldiers and helicopters reminiscent of the Vietnam War and the American Eagle with the American flag. So that's very patriotic. On the bottom here you see a lot of the flower work. Once again, we're our culture has a lot of flowers that we used in a lot of the festivals and decorations. You follow me again? Now, a lot of this work here is a continuation of the decorative aspects of our culture. And then we have an eagle. Now, this part here, Carlos Rivas, who was one of our artists, painted this. Now, he painted this using spray cans. And a lot of the other art that you see over there was used using brushes, using acrylic paint. We used something like 30 gallons of paint to do a lot of this work. It probably was a lot more, but that's what we purchased. And one of the interesting things about it is that we had to pay to paint, because we had to park, and the parking is $1.50 an hour. So we spent a lot of time painting. We come up in the morning and bring out the scaffolding and set it up. And there's a lot of traffic through here. As you can see, all the deliveries come through here. And so there was barely enough room for our scaffolding and the trucks, the 18-wheelers, to come by and deliver the goods. So that was very interesting. One of the things that did happen, though, is one of our artists, and I won't mention names, fell off the scaffolding and broke two ribs. And so we can literally say that, you know, we worked our to the bone with blood and guts. Okay, if you follow me here, we have the American flag, Arizona, and another flag, which I'm not sure what Carlos meant for that, but anyway, it's right there. Moving along, these images over here were done by Edgar and other people, and Ramon, and they're reminiscent of the Mesoamerica type of art with a contemporary look to it. You can see on the bottom here, you have the hummingbirds, you have the images of the Mayans. Hope you're enjoying this. Okay, here we have Carlos Santana, smooth man. This was done, once again, a lot of this work is done by several artists. Ramon Aguirre started this, and then Jose Giron finished part of it, and then I did the background. So it's always a collaboration, because once again, some of the artists come in and paint, and you know, they have other responsibilities, and so the work doesn't get done. And so Andres and I come in and kind of finish it up. So a lot of it's collaboration. The American Sabor was a group that came to Alec, and they put together a really nice show that lasted a couple of months, and it featured all of the music legends with a lot of booths that had all their historical aspects and their records and their music. And so it was really a phenomenal experience that we had. And then we have the bottom here, we have Lalo Guerrero, once again, a really popular musician, singer. And once again, everybody likes him. So this is one of the things that when people come by here, we have a lot of people that come and do shoots here. They do fashion shoots, they do a lot of the ASU comes here and they do film shoots. And so this is a really popular place for that. And as you can see, we had one time we had a whole team of of basketball players that came in and did a shoot. One of the things that we do also is that we bring in by bus a lot of the students from different schools, and they come in and they have a lunch, and then we have a lecture, which lecture on, for example, our artwork and what meaning of a lot of the paintings that you see inside. And so they have a really good time, and we have a repeat. They come every year, and so that's something that's really exciting for us that we do. If you continue here, here's on top we have a picture of Vicente Fernandez. And once again, excellent music that you can hear from him. He's on the City of Phoenix, and this is one that I did. And on the bottom here you have the Zoot Suit, and kind of a look at the Phoenix, Adams Street, where we're located at. Once again, just reminiscent of the Zoot Suits. And if you look into history, the Zoot Suits riots in LA during World War II were made a lot of news. As you come down here, this work is by our director, Elizabeth Toledo, and she does a lot of the Llorona. She also does a really nice singing that goes along with it. So she's a wonderful singer, and she's a wonderful artist. And there's a whole long story behind this. If you get a chance, Google all these names, and you'll get the whole story behind them. By the way, this is she uses her daughter as a model. So she has very pretty models. And if you walk over here, now some of this work over here was done by kind of traveling artists. They came in and they heard about what we were doing, and they just wanted to get some paint on the wall. And so they came in and painted some of these things up here. If you go down here, you have the old truck, reminiscent of the lowriders and our culture with our automobiles. You have the Mexican Golden Eagle. And here we have Larry Fitzgerald. Everybody knows about him. Hopefully he's going to be here for another season. I hope so. And you have over here, you have Frida. And once again, she is an icon. I first saw her show when I was in New Zealand. It was of all places to see her show, but it was here in Phoenix too. But I saw it. It's a wonderful exhibit. If he ever comes again, you should be sure to watch it. On the bottom here we have the hummingbird and the flowers, and these here were done by various artists, and once again I had to come back in and finish them up. And so I did the backgrounds and I finished the detail. Same thing with this one over here. It's an indigenous lady with the meaning of the owl, and I'm not quite sure what the meaning of the owl is, but it does have significance. As we move along here, you have on the bottom, you have the jaguar. The Aztecs had the jaguar warriors, which were very fierce, and there was a whole ritual to their training and being able to go and capture the prisoners for their ceremonies, where they would open up their chest and get out their heart. So it was very interesting. Then we have here some of the look at some of the indigenous work. And there's also a legend with the earth and the fish and the water. So that's kind of a little story on that. And finally, on the last here, we have, this was done by Andres. And it has the folklorico ladies and the vaqueros in the background. And then all of the artists that took place in painting this mural. And I'll just read you the names if you can't read them. They are Jose Andres Giron, Roman Reyes, Ramon Aguirre, Edgar Fernandez, Elizabeth Toledo, Alfredo Bilducia, Noreen Ayon, Tavo Barrios, Angel Diaz, Carlito Espinosa, Ivan Garcia, Luis and Edgar Muñoz, Ray Lugo, Raul Rodriguez, y Catalina Falseri. Bueno, I hope you enjoyed this little history lesson that we have here. I invite you to come in and learn a little bit more, because We really enjoy it. You know, it took us a long time. The city was good enough to let us use this space. And, you know, it went, a lot of work went into it. And so we hope that you enjoy it. And once again, this is Roman Reyes. This is El Arte que te impulsa. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time.